So today was epic. Wanna know why? This was how my day started. So hey guys, I think I didn't plan out this trip too well. Distance wise, it should have just been about 10 kilometers. Well, what's happening is it's got too much uphill, so now my board is basically dead. So it's gonna be a fun trip going home. So anyway, I'll still try to get to my destination. So for today's vlog, I'm gonna be talking about 8 things that makes a male's heart and a female's heart different. Come in. Whew! Right up. So to make the long story short, I got to my destination, realized it was not the destination I wanted to go to, and I just found out there was nothing great to shoot there. So, let's jump into this. Aman here, and you're watching Heart Limits. So what are the 8 differences between a man and a woman's heart? Well, let's start with number 1. Number 1 is about the size and the weight. Did you know that a woman's heart is actually 2/3 the size and 2/3 the weight of a man's heart? It's quite interesting when you think about it that way, right? And in my previous video, I did mention that a heart is the average size of a human fist. So imagine if you're a man, you look at your hand, 2/3 of that is a woman's heart. It's pretty small and it's quite interesting that it's small, right? So what are the complications with it being small? Well, first of all, it's harder to operate on. And of course, since it's harder to operate on, there's lots of things that are harder to spot. So just to give you a surprising fact, whenever there is heart transplant, what happens is even though if the patient is a woman, there are quite a number of instances where the heart being transplanted is a male's heart for the reason that it's bigger and there's more room to work in. So that is number 1. Number 2 is about the veins and the arteries. Well, one interesting thing about it is given that the heart is smaller and lighter for women, so doesn't it also mean that the arteries and veins should also be smaller? Well, technically they're not really smaller, but they're thinner. And for arteries, it's more towards the idea that it's also lighter. So the problem with this is that with it being quite thin, the veins and the arteries, what happens is it's more sensitive and it's more prone and it's harder to manage. Problem is there are times where it tends to shrivel. So what is shrivel? To shrivel means that it actually wrinkles and it also contracts. Just so you're aware, it's actually thinner by 1 millimeter. It's quite interesting, right? It's quite, given that it's already quite thin a thing and it's 1 millimeter thinner. And with the arteries, the problem is it gives some complications when it undergoes examinations such as angiography, angioplasty, and even coronary bypass surgery. So I want you to keep that in mind, all right? Number 3 is the number of beats. With a woman, their heart actually beats more in comparison to a man. So for women, on average, their hearts would normally beat around 78 to 82 beats per minute. But with a man, it only beats at 70 to 72 beats per minute. So that's actually quite a gap, right? Just surprising in that aspect. But the thing is, it's true that women's hearts beat more. But one interesting thing about it is that even though it beats more, their hearts actually pump blood 10% less in comparison to a man. And the problem is, since women's hearts beat pretty fast, they're more prone to palpitations and even shortness of breath complaints. So, keep that in mind. That is number 3. Okay? Number 4 is how men and women differ with their reaction to stress. With stress, what happens is normally, both for men and women, their heart rates and their blood pressure rises. Well, that's a given fact, you know, because your heart suddenly starts and you start to tighten up and everything. But the thing is, with women, their heart rate goes higher in comparison to men. And the thing is, of course, since the heart rate goes higher, that means they pump more blood in comparison to men. But for men, on the other hand, it's different. What happens is their heart rate also does go up, but not as high as women's. But what happens is their blood pressure goes surprisingly quite high in comparison to women. And the thing is, this is mainly because for a man, their blood vessels tend to contract whenever they are stressed. Number 5, difference is the defensive properties. So, with women in general, they're actually, you could say, quite lucky because they have not undergone menopause in their early stages. Their estrogen level is quite high. And what does estrogen have to do with anything? Well, what estrogen does is mainly two things. Estrogen helps in keeping blood vessels healthy, and it also keeps cholesterol levels in a safe level or limit or amount or whatever, it's the same thing. And with putting into consideration the concept of menopause, well, since estrogen levels are high before menopause, that makes women at an advantage for about 10 years. Well, normally, a heart disease surfaces at the age of 30 up, so usually that's for men. And for women, it's the, since they have, you know, that estrogen level plus, they have this advantage of a 10 years. So more or less, they usually have heart problems 40 up. But there are certain complications. So what complications am I talking about? Well, let's say for instance, a woman has a deficiency of estrogen while she is young. Problem with this is that that woman is 7 times more likely to have a heart disease at a young age, and more so when she gets older. Because imagine, she already has a deficiency, and when she eventually gets menopause, that was a really bad whistle. That's better. So imagine, it's like a double tap kind of kill, right? It's whoo! With menopause, there's also 3 things that come into mind. So number 1 is your comorbid risk factors. Number 2 is your metabolic syndrome. Number 3 is your systolic blood pressure. So with these 3 things, these are other complications that increases whenever a woman has menopause. There's also other things which actually come into play whenever we talk about defensive properties of the heart. Diabetes, hypertension, smoking, and alcohol. So a thing is, women are more, how would you say, less in defense when it comes to these types of things. And it's actually quite unfair, I have to say. Because it's true that, you know, we were supposedly made equal in some way. But it's how the genes are, it's how people are made. Men can basically take two beers. Whatever. They can take more alcohol, almost double the quantity in comparison to a woman. And also the problem is with women is that they are more reactive to certain intake of drugs. So normally when you intake drugs at some or some type of drug, there are certain side effects. So some side effects have a higher chance of rising with women in comparison to men. Also, when we get into the concept of pregnancy, anti-pregnancy pills, contraception pills, and also smoking, makes women more prone to have clots, you know, blood clots, which is also pretty bad because clot can be in complicated places. Women, they are really vulnerable whenever they get an illness when they're pregnant. It could actually affect them in the long run and increases their chances to actually have heart disease in the future, which is, I have to say, quite sad and quite hard. Whew. So that's number 5 in how their hearts are different in defensive properties. Okay? Mm-hmm. I'm gonna go back to my sofa. Ha-ha! Number 6 is about the durability of the heart. A man's heart is more durable in the sense that whenever it gets an attack or a problem, you could say, it's more fixable. And the problem is with women, their hearts become really weak once they suffer an attack. So durability-wise, whew, men have an advantage once again, which is quite sad again for women. So that's how the cookie crumbles. That's number 6. Gonna be giving you number 7 soon. Number 7. Difference in their hearts also comes with the symptoms that are involved. And the problem is with women, their symptoms are not what you would call typical, so they would be atypical. With it being atypical, they're harder to spot, harder to prevent, harder to notice. So what are the big differences, right? So in general, the classic way is that you'll have a certain type of chest pain. It can also be a type of sweating. You know, you suddenly start to sweat a lot. What the hell is going on? It could also be a certain type of pain or discomfort, which can be either in your neck, in your shoulders, in your arms, basically somewhere above your upper body. And the thing is with women, they also have the possibility to have these types of symptoms. But with chest pain, it's only at like, what, 30-ish percent? So they are more prone to have other symptoms. Symptoms such as shortness of breath. You know, suddenly they feel weak. They suddenly feel overly fatigued. They will have a pain in their jaw. It's quite interesting, it's a jaw. I almost had a lockjaw. That was a bad idea. Oh. It could also be nausea or a certain type of vomiting. It can also be a type of bloating, and in some cases, it could even be it could be like sleeping problems, or it could also be a type of indigestion. So that's where the digestion came in. So yeah, so for women, the problem is given that these reactions at some times are actually quite normal side effects to small things, it's harder to spot for women. And of course, the thing is, given that it's a symptom, there are symptoms that actually rise usually a month before you have an attack, and there are symptoms that rise during your attack. The thing is, for women, it's pretty mixed up and it's quite confusing because you're like, all right, a month ago, I suddenly had this feeling of indigestion. Could have just been that you ate something bad or something. But in the end, it has something to do with your heart. So, because of that, and because of the atypical symptoms, doctors have a harder time spotting that there's actually something wrong. So that is number 7. All right, number 7. Wait, where did I come from? All right, and that is number 7. All right, keep that in mind. Number 7. Woo! So number 8 is heart attack and treatment. Let's start with what is a heart attack. So in general, a heart attack usually happens when the coronary arteries that supply the blood to the heart develop a certain type of blockage, or I guess you could say plaque. You know, it's like in teeth. Ah, there's plaque stuck in my tooth. Well, yeah, it's kind of the same concept, but it's with the arteries that gets blocked with that plaque. And for men, it's actually quite simple in their case in some way. That when they have a heart attack or about to have a heart attack, what happens is you can actually spot that plaque, and it's quite evident and clear that it actually sticks out to the vessel. So the beauty with it sticking out to the vessel is that it's so easy to spot that doctors normally wouldn't have much of a problem taking out that plaque. Well, of course, there's lots of complications when you undergo surgery, but that's a different story. So for men, it's easier to spot. But the thing is, with women, there also is a chance that that plaque, you know, like the tooth, that plaque can also stick out. But there is a big chance that it's more on the blood vessels being reactive. And by reactive, I mean that they squeeze and spasm really rapidly. So with that, it's harder to spot it for women once again. And the thing is, in 60% of the cases, it's actually not a plaque problem of it being stuck in the vessel, sticking out, but it's something else. So which makes the process of treatment for doctors whenever there's a heart attack pretty difficult. And when we get into treatment for men, treatment and examination, I guess you could say, for men it's easier to be done, because the thing is, things are seen clearly. The heart is bigger, the veins are bigger and thicker, technically thicker, yeah, thicker. But for women, it's the other way around. It is a smaller space to work with, thinner, more sensitive veins, so whew, complique. And the problem is, with women, their treatment is in a way undertreated, for the reason that they believe that certain methodologies for men would work for women, or would rather be that it's too strong for a woman to get into this type of treatment. Well, the thing is, there's lots of studies that are missing for women. Well, of course, nowadays there's more awareness that women's heart complications are a totally different story. So now they're eventually getting into more studies, more research on how effective treatments can be done for women. The treatment for women has been so left behind when it comes to heart disease in comparison to men, mainly because whenever they conduct examinations, they conduct surveys and tests, it's such a big bulk that's being concentrated on men, and they don't factor in so many considerations on certain factors which only work for women. And the thing is, some treatments work better for women in comparison to men, but there's no real studies or evidence that shows which treatments are those. So guys, that is the 8 differences between how men's and women's hearts are. So I hope you like this video. I hope you find it helpful. I hope the world pays more attention to treating women with heart disease. And I hope that you can subscribe to my channel and like. And thank you once again for listening. Aman here, and you're watching